Hello everyone, myself Dr. Pratik Nahar, and today we are going to discuss about the DFA or FA. So that is this topic is belongs to the formal language automata and theory of computation subject. So this is the basic fundamental topic of the subject. So what is DFA or FA? What is the difference between DFA and FA? Before considering that, first we look the structure of a grammar. So basically the grammar is divided in four criteria. So that is type 3 grammar, that is type 2 grammar, type 1 and type 0. This hierarchy is called Chomsky hierarchy. So on the basis of this Chomsky hierarchy, the finite automata or theory of computation or formal language automata, these subjects are based on this Chomsky hierarchy. Basically, there are four types of classification or grammar. Type 3 is the most restricted grammar. Type 3 stands for most restricted grammar, and for this restricted grammar we construct finite automata or DFA. On the basis of the grammar structure we define FA or DFA. Then comes type 2, that is called context free grammar, that is stands for CFG stands for context free grammar, and to implement this context free grammar we use PDA. And that is the machine. The full form of PDA is push down automata. Then the higher version of grammar, that is type 2, and type 2 is context sensitive grammar. And for this context sensitive grammar we use or we draw a machine that is called linear bounded automata, LBA. LBA stands for linear bounded automata. And the last classification, that is called type 0, that is unrestricted grammar. Means there is no restriction on the grammar. We can use any kind of sentence to construct the machine. And to support this unrestricted grammar, we use Turing machine. The machine which is designed to support the unrestricted grammar or type 0 grammar is called the Turing machine. Okay, so these are the classification of a Chomsky hierarchy. On the basis of these four classification, we define grammar, which kind of grammar we are having. The type 3, the most restricted grammar, that is called the regular grammar. Okay, this type 3 is the restricted grammar and we call the regular grammar. On the basis of this regular grammar, we draw a DFA and FA. Now the meaning of regular grammar means there is no ambiguity in the sentence or no ambiguity in the syntax. As I am communicating to you, the same meaning is communicated in your mind as it is. So that is called the unrestricted grammar or pure form of the grammar. Okay, restricted grammar. Then on the basis of this classification we are going to discuss only in today's lecture, that is type 3, or we call the finite automata or a DFA. Okay, so let's move to the topic.
Yeah.
So how to represent this grammar in machine form? Basically, we are considering all these languages from the point of view system. So how to implement these languages in a system or using the language to accommodate this kind of classification, we use these different machines. Like if someone is provided us some kind of input, so on the basis of that input, we say, yes, that is, input is belongs to particular grammar or particular machine. On the basis of that machine, by analyzing or recognizing the input on by that machine, we classify that the sentence or the example belongs to the particular language. Okay. So let's move to the DFA. DFA or finite automata. As I have already told you, it is belong to the type 3 grammar. So type 3 grammar is regular grammar. Type 3 is regular grammar, and for that regular grammar, we draw, we design a DFA machine. So how to define this DFA? So basically, DFA is defined on 5 tuples. Okay, that is 5 tuples. And these 5 tuples are, that is capital Q, summation, capital F, Q0 and delta. On the basis of these 5 mathematical tuples, we define our DFA or machine. Now, what are these tuples? So first of all, we consider that individual tuple, that is capital Q. Capital Q is a finite set of input alphabet. Finite set of input alphabets. Okay. As I already told you, this is the type representation of a grammar. So grammar is in the form of alphanumeric. Okay, or some special symbols are considered. So that input is a alphanumeric or special symbol. So capital Q is a finite set of input alphabet. That means there is a some limit of input that we can count or we can calculate. So that is why we use the terminology finite. Then comes the capital F. Capital F is again finite set of final states. Final states. Okay. Now the machine is there, DFA or FA. As we are providing some input to the machine, so we expect some output from the machine, and that output is either accepted or rejected. Correct? As FA, DFA, or DFA belongs to the type 3 grammar, regular grammar, if some person is provided as a kind of input, say sentence double AB or is I am okay, kind of that sentences. So on the basis of that sentence, that machine DFA or FA will only say as accepted or rejected, whether this sentence or this string belongs to the regular grammar or regular language or not. That's it. So finite, capital F is a finite set of final states. That means there are some final states in DFA which recognize or which tell us that this string is accepted. Okay. Now comes the next, that is Q0. Q0 is stands for initial state. Q0 stands for initial state from where our machine starts. Like if we enter in a room, so there is a dark. If we switch on the light, if we want to switch on the light, we just turn on the switch. So that state, the switch is in the off state. We just press that switch and it change its state from initial state to some other state. So that is Q0, from where our machine will start. So Q0 is the initial state. Okay. Then the next terminology is summation. So summation is a finite, just a minute. So summation is a finite set of input alphabet. Okay, and this is a finite set of states. Capital Q is a finite set of states, capital F is a finite set of final states, Q0 is an initial state, summation is a finite set of input alphabet. I have already told you alphanumeric and special symbol, and at the end delta. Delta is called the transition or mapping function. So what is delta and how to define that delta? Okay, so here is delta. Delta is a transition or mapping function between capital Q and summation. Capital Q stands for finite set of states and summation is stands for finite set of input alphabet. So on the particular state, what input we are getting on how to react for that input, whether we change state or if we change state, what is the state? So that combination is defined by this delta. So these are the five basic tuples on which we define our DFA. Capital Q, summation, capital F, capital Q0 and delta. Okay. So now let's move how to generate a machine for a particular problem on the basis of these five tuples. So we take some examples, couple of examples, 2-3 examples to get exactly what is DFA and how to draw a DFA for a particular language in real life problems. So generate a DFA for a given problem or for a given language. So a language is an example or a kind of input for the DFA. So suppose there is a language that is on the input alphabet set A comma B star. That means summation is a set of finite input alphabet. So A comma star means any combination of AB, the string generated on the basis of any combination of AB, that is summation, provided condition string ends with AB. Correct? So this is the language or this is the problem. We are supposed to draw a DFA for this language. Again, I'll just explain this language. Language says all the string accepted by the machine which ends with AB on the combination of input alphabet AB. So what is the first process to draw a DFA? That is find the input alphabet set. Find the input string set. Now, A plus B star, that means star means from 0 to infinity, no limitation. So there are infinite combinations, but we are supposed to generate only possible combination on the basis of that we can generate a generalized DFA or generalized machine. So the input alphabet set, that is W, is defined as the set of string on input alphabet AB that always ends with AB. So the minimum possible length of a string is AB. Only AB is the minimum string length which ends with AB. Then next minimum possible length of a string is double AB, as AB is at the end. Next minimum possible length is AB. Okay. As AB is at the end. Again, no limitation, either string is start with A or start with B. So B, AB, again string ends with B. Another combination of string, that is ABAB, string end with AB, and BBAB, and so on. So we are supposed to generate a few set of strings on the basis of the language so that we can draw our machine. So we start from the minimum possible length of a string, that is AB. On the basis of this language, that the machine will accept, or this language will generate all the strings over the input alphabet combination AB that ends with AB. So that is the minimum possible length of a string. So now how to draw a DFA from this minimum possible length of a string? So as I have already told you, Q0 is an initial state from our machine will start. So Q0 is initial state. Now, AB is our input. So first of all, we read A. Okay. So from Q0 to Q1, we are reading input alphabet A. Okay. So here is A. So this diagram is implies that Q0 is initial state, and how to define an initial state using arrow. If there is an arrow on any state, that means that state is initial state. So Q0 is initial state. On Q0 state, we get an input alphabet A, as A is the first alphabet of our string. So we get A. So we just change the state from Q0 to Q1. Okay. Next, the input alphabet is B, which we are supposed to read. And what is our current state? Now we are on Q1. So Q1 is our current state. So at Q1, we are reading input alphabet B. So here is Q1. Okay. From Q1, we read input alphabet B, and that is some state QF. So by reading this input alphabet, our machine will say that yes, this string is accepted. Why? Because this string is generated on the basis of this language. Okay. So by reading input alphabet AB, we are at the end in final state QF. So QF is the final state, and we denote final state by double circle. If in our DFA, any state having double circle, that means it is a final state. That means after reading the whole string, if we are in the this state QF, that string is accepted, otherwise it is rejected. Okay. So this is the first set of string, first example of set of string from our set, that is AB. Now we are supposed to apply the combination. As user can pass any combination, triple AB, AB, AB. So by reading that input, it is our machine task to identify that this language or this string belongs to this language or not. So we are going to apply the combination of AB on each and every state. So at Q0, we have already transition of A. Now for B, if there is B, then it is a self loop. That implies if we are having AB, and before that, if we have double B, triple B, and so on, doesn't matter. Okay, it doesn't matter. So once we have AB, before that we can have any number of B. So for that any number of B, we define a self loop. From Q0, we read B and we move to Q0. So at Q0 state, we have defined two transition for two input alphabet, that is for A and for B. Next, at Q1. Q1 already B input alphabet transition is defined. Now we are supposed to define transition for A. Now what happened? If A occurs at Q1, so what are the possibilities? Basically, there are three possibilities to move forward. Like first possibility, second possibility, and third possibility. There are only three states. So we can move from Q1 to Q0 or Q1 or QF. These are the three possibilities we have for A input alphabet at Q1 state. So which one is correct? We have to find that. So let's see. So we'll check it one by one. Which possibility? Sorry, this is A, my mistake. This is A, not B. So we'll check one by one. Like if I move from Q0, I have read A, then I jump to Q1 state, and at Q1 state, suppose my input alphabet is this, double A, B. So for this A, I have jumped from Q0 to Q1. Now for this A, I'm supposed to draw a transition from Q2. So first possibility, if I draw this transition from Q1 to Q0, what is the output? This is the string which is accepted. Why? Because this string is just exactly according to the language. It is having AB at the end. Yes, it is having AB at the end. So by reading this string, our machine will fall at the final state. But as I have defined transition from Q1 to Q0 using A, so what will happen? We'll start again from initial state Q0. Q0 pe we read A. So we'll jump to Q1. Q1 pe we read next input alphabet, that is A. So we'll move to Q0. And at Q0, we read B. So we are on Q0. So this is not a final state. By reading the string, we are at some state that is not a final state. That means this string is rejected by the DFA. But this is not the case. This is the correct string. According to the language, our machine must accept it. That means the transaction which we have defined, it is incorrect. So this possibility at Q1, if we read A, we move to Q0, this is wrong. So we'll move or we'll check the next possibility for this input alphabet. That is, what if I move to QF? At Q1 state, if I read A, then I'll jump to QF, then what will happen? So let's see. So if a user passed AA, user is free to pass any string. It is our job to identify or recognize that machine, that string by machine, or say whether this string is accepted or not on the basis of this language. So user have passed AA. This string does not belong to this language. Why? Because at the end we need AB. Here is no AB. Here is AA. That means this string is rejected by the machine. Our machine will have to reject this machine. But let's see. If I do transition from Q1 to QF for A, what will happen? So from initial state, we'll start from Q0. Q0 will read first A. So Q0 to A, transition is defined. We'll jump to Q1. And at Q1, we read another A, second A. So from Q1 to A, we jump to QF. And that is a final state. It implies, that means our DFA will say, yes, AA is accepted because we are in the final state. But this AA is not belongs to the language. That means this transaction is also incorrect. So now what is the last possibility? Only that is self loop on Q1 for A. Okay. Now if a user pass AA from Q0 to A, Q1, Q1 to A, Q1. Again, for AA, our machine will halt on Q1. That is not a final state. That means our machine will say this string is rejected, and that is perfectly okay according to the problem. Next, so at Q0 we have defined transition for A and B. At Q1 we have defined transition for B and A both. Now at last state QF, what will happen and how to define a transition at QF for A and B? So let's see. When will we reach QF by reading the minimum input from Q0 to Q1? So A, B. By reading AB from Q0 to QF. Q0 pe first we read A, we'll jump to Q1. Q1 pe we read B, we'll jump to QF. Now we are at QF state. Now what are the possibility? If user pass B, then this string is accepted by the machine or rejected by the machine? Yes, definitely. This string is rejected. Why rejected? Because it does not have AB at the end. It is having double B at the end. So what is the transaction? If at QF we got B, so we'll jump to Q0. We'll jump to Q0. Again, how you can identify that for input alphabet B from QF will jump to Q0? There are two possibilities also there. We can move to Q1 and we can stand on QF also. So let's check the possibility one by one and kill the possibility which are not correct. That is the basic way to draw the DFA. Okay. So what if I put self loop at Q0? Self loop of B at Q0. So what will happen if a user pass A double B as a string? So this A double B is accepted. Why? From initial state Q0 pe we read A, Q0 se A read karke Q1. Then at Q1 we read B, from Q1 by reading B we jump to QF. And at final state QF, by reading this last B, we are defining the transition self loop. So QF to QF, so at the end finally we are on final state. That implies this string is accepted, but according to the language it will not be accepted. That means this transaction is false or incorrect. So we just kill the one possibility, that is QF per B ke liye will jump to QF. Next possibility, what if I'll jump here? Okay. So again, by reading Q0 at Q0 state, we read A, will jump to Q1. Then Q1 by reading B will move to QF, and QF by reading B will move to Q1, and again by reading B we'll move to QF. So this is the minimum possible length of a string. By reading this, we'll jump to QF. Again, this is not the according to the language. At the end, there is double B. We are supposing AB. That means this transition is also incorrect. This transition is accepting an invalid string. That is why we are removing this transition from our DFA. Now, what is the possibility? Only last possibility has left. That is from QF, if B input alphabet is there, we'll move to Q0. Okay. So at QF we define B input alphabet. Now what about A? At QF if we got A. So how we will reach QF from initial state Q0? By reading minimum input alphabet. So minimum input alphabet is AB. At Q0 we read A, we'll jump to Q1. At Q1 we'll read B, we'll be on QF. Now at QF we are having A. So what is the transition? What we are supposed to do for this A input alphabet at QF, on which state we are supposed to transit? So again, there are three possibilities. We can stand on QF, we'll jump from QF to Q1, and we can jump from QF to Q0. So let's see one by one each possibility. Again, if I'll put self loop on it, that means implies this string is accepted, but according to the language, it is not accepted. So this transition is false. Then what is the next possibility? If I'll put A over here. Okay. So Q0 to A read karke Q1, Q1 to B read karke QF, QF again by reading A, we are on Q1. So by this input, if user pass only this input ABA, by reading this input, we are on Q1 state, and Q1 is not a final state. That means this string is rejected by the machine, and that is okay. Why? Because again it is not having AB. So this language does not belong to the this string does not belong to the language. Okay, now next possibility, if I'll get B over here. So yes, this string is according to the language. That means this string is accepted by our DFA. So let's see. At Q0 we got A, we'll move to Q1. At Q1 we'll got B, we'll move to QF. At QF we got A, we'll again jump to Q1. And at Q1 we got B, transition is also defined, we'll move to QF. So by reading complete string, we are on QF state, and that is final state. That implies yes, this string is accepted, and yes, it is correct because it is having AB at the end. So this is the finalized DFA. This is the final DFA according to the language. As we are having AB transition on each and every state, at Q0 we are having AB, at Q1 we are having AB, and at QF we are having AB. That means this is a DFA. This is the finalized DFA machine according to the question. Now if user pass any kind of string over the combination of input alphabet AB, if that string is having AB at the end, that machine will accept it, otherwise it is rejected. Let's see, have some examples, because we have to validate this machine, whether the machine is correct or not. So let's see, if user pass a string, random string, okay, double A, BA, BA, AB. So according to the language, at the end we need AB. Yes, here it is. That means by reading this string, our DFA will finally stands on final state, that is QF. So let's see, we'll start from Q0 state. At Q0 we get input alphabet A, so we'll move to Q1, transition is defined. Then at Q1 state we get next input alphabet, that is A, so that is self loop, we are on Q1 state. And at Q1 state next input alphabet is B, so Q1 pay we read B, so we'll move to QF. Then on QF we read next input alphabet, that is A, so from QF we read A, we'll jump to Q1. Then Q1 we read B, Q1 to B, again QF, Q1 to A, QF, QF, next input alphabet is A, we'll jump to Q1. Then Q1 input alphabet A, so input alphabet A, we are on Q1. And at the end Q1, the present state is Q1, and last input alphabet is B, so Q1 to B, QF. So by reading this complete string, we are on final state, that is QF. That means yes, this string is accepted by the machine. Okay, so this is the final DFA. DFAs stands for deterministic finite automata, which we design for regular languages or regular grammar. Okay. Now I wrote a terminology over here, that is DFA/FA. Now what is difference between this DFA and FA? So in DFA, if we are having two input alphabet in our input alphabet set, so in DFA, at each and every state we need exactly two input alphabet transition for A and B. For both input alphabet A and B, we need exactly two transition at each state. If it happened, then that is called the DFA, otherwise that is called the FA. So let me give you an example. Suppose I remove this transition from Q1. Okay, so this is called the FA, not the DFA. Why? Because at Q1 we are having only transition for B input alphabet, not for A. So it is not a complete for input alphabet. So this is a FA, not a DFA. Okay, so this is the minor difference between FA and DFA. FA does not have all the transition at all the states according to the input alphabet, but if it is a DFA, then it must have each and every state having complete transition for the input alphabet. If we have two input alphabet in our transition input alphabet set, then we need exactly two transition at each and every state. Suppose there is another input alphabet, that is C. So we are having three input alphabet in our input alphabet set, that is A, B and C. Then for this machine to become a DFA, we need C transition at each and every state. I'm just defining it randomly. So if this kind of a state or this kind of a transition, then it will a DFA, otherwise it is a FA, finite automata. Okay. So this is a basic example or how to draw a DFA. We'll take another example and we take another look how to generate a DFA for the given language. See, we'll get different examples or different problems for the DFA, NFA, PDA and so on, but the logic is same. If we got the logic, then we can draw DFA or FA very easily. There is only two basic steps. First, find the minimum possible length of a string according to the language. The minimum possible length of a string that is generated by the language, and by using that minimum possible length of a string, just draw a DFA for each and every input alphabet, move to the next state, and then apply the combination over that states. This is the basic fundamental to draw the DFA. Okay, so we are going to take another example on DFA or FA. So suppose there is a language on input alphabet, that is 0, 1 star. That means any combination of 0, 1 star is for infinity, provided condition string must have 0, 1, or just let me change the statement, must start with 0. Okay, so here is the simple problem. There is a language over the input alphabet 0, 1, which says it will accept or it will generate the string which always starts with 0. Okay, so what is the first task? We are supposed to generate a string set. Okay, on the basis of this string set, we'll generate a DFA machine. So what is the minimum possible length of a string which is generated by this language? So minimum possible length of a string which is generated by this language is 0, because it is the starting symbol, the string starts with 0 and nothing else. So this is the minimum possible length of a string. Second minimum possible length of a string is 0, 1, or we can say that 0, 0. Okay, according to the language, what we need, the string must start with 0, that's it. After that, any occurrence of 0, 1 doesn't matter. So 0 start with 0, after that 1 start with 0, after that 0. So this is the second minimum possible length of a string. This is first because it is having 1 as a length, this is having 2 as a length. Then next, minimum possible length of a string is 000 or 010 or 001 or 011. Okay, that is combinations. That is, the string length is 3. For 3 length, we have 4 different combination according to the language, and so on. So by using this string set, we are going to generate a DFA. So again, first of all, we start from Q0 state. So here is our Q0 state, that is a starting state. Now, first of all, we start from the minimum possible length of a string, that is 0. So for 0 input alphabet, at Q0 state, by reading 0 input alphabet, we are moving from Q0 to QF. That is our final state. That's it. This DFA will define only that the string starts with 0. That's it. So Q0, by reading 0, we'll move from Q0 to QF, and that is accepted. Okay, now we'll apply different combinations over here. As the language says, the string always must start with 0. So it is 0. Then next possible length of a string is either 00 or 01. So we are supposed to define the combination at QF. What happened if we get 0 at QF? There are two possibilities. We'll stand on QF or we'll move to Q0. So let's see one by one. This is our input alphabet. By reading this first 0, we'll move from Q0 to QF. And for this second 0, what happened? If I'll move over here from Q0 to QF, I define this transition. So let's see what happened. 00 is in our string set. That means this string is generated by the language. It implies our DFA must accept this string. That means by reading this input string, our DFA must finally stand on in the final state. So at Q0 state, by reading first input alphabet 0, we are on QF. By reading this second, if we define the transition from QF to Q0, so by reading 00, we are in Q0 state, and that is not a final state. That means this string is rejected. But that is not a case. This string is according to the language. That means the transition which we have defined is incorrect. So we are supposed to correct it. So what is another possibility? That is self loop. Okay. So from Q0, by reading 0, we are in QF state, and at QF, by reading 0, we are again in QF state. So by reading 00, at the end we are in QF state, and that is accepting state, final state. So string is accepted. Then if user pass 3x0, 4x0, then it will accepted by this DFA. Now next, what will happen if we take this input alphabet 01? Okay. So from Q0, by reading 0, we are in QF state. So it is done. Now we'll talk about this one input alphabet. At QF, we are supposed to define a transition for one input alphabet. So what happen if I again transit it into from QF to Q0? So let's see. By reading 01, Q0 say reading 0 QF, and at QF, by reading 1, we are in Q0 state. Again, this is from our input alphabet set, or this is from the language. As the string is started with 0, that means this is accepted, but we are in Q0, that is not a final state. That means the string is rejected by the DFA. It implies the transition which we have defined is also incorrect. So we are supposed to correct it. So how to correct it? Again, either define another self loop or just by defined by comma. Both are same. So we'll use the terminology comma. So that means by reading 0 from Q0, we are in QF, and at QF, by reading 1, we are in QF. That's it. So it will accept the transition. Now, what if user pass 10? As user have the freedom over the input alphabet combination 01, so he or she can pass any input. So what if user pass 10? As the language says, the string must start with 0. It will not start from 1. So at Q0 state, we have to define if there is an input alphabet Q1, so we will move to a dead state. Anna? We will move in a dead state. So at Q0, if we get one input alphabet from Q0, we'll move to Q1. And at Q1, any combination of 0, 1 occur will remain in Q1. So this state is called dead state. Dead state. Why? because once we jumped into this state, we cannot go from this state for any input. 0, 1, any combination will always stand in this state. So if user pass 1, 0, by at Q0 state by reading 1, will move to Q1, and at Q1 will read 0, we are again in Q1. So by reading 1, 0, we are in Q1 state, and that is not a final state. That means this string is rejected. So this is the final DFA for the given language. Again, why DFA? That is deterministic finite automata. As definition says, if we are having two input alphabet, 0 and 1, we are having two input alphabet. So for these two input alphabet, at each and every state we have to define two input alphabet. At Q0, 0 is defined, 1 is defined. At QF, 0 is defined, 1 is defined. And at Q1, 0 and 1. So all three state having exactly two transition, that is belongs to our input alphabet. That is why this is a DFA. Okay, if I remove this dead state, so this is the final DFA according to the language, and if I remove this dead state, suppose for example, there is no dead state which is defined by us, okay, and according to the language we have defined only this DFA. So what is this? It is DFA or FA? It is a FA. Why? Because at Q1 state, there is only single transition for input alphabet 0. There is no transition for 1. That means it is a FA. Now, what will happen if user pass 1, 0? So at Q0 state, we are supposed to read input alphabet 1. But there is no transition. So our machine will halt. Halt means there is no transition. So by default, it is accepted as a rejection of a string. So this is a FA. This is not a DFA. Why? Because at Q0, we don't have a transition for input alphabet 1, so this is FA. If we define the transition, then it will become a DFA. So this is all about DFA, how to draw a DFA, what are the basic terminology of a DFA. On basically, 5 tuples we define DFA, and that 5 tuples are the combination of this DFA. Okay, so thank you.